Next, we'll take a look at adding some enemies and killing them creatively with something that's not Ellen's gun or staff. We'll also look at adding a health pickup because we're likely to lose some health in this area. So I'm going to exit play mode. I'm going to move Ellen past this puzzle so we can quickly test things out. So once again, in the hierarchy, I'm going to click on Ellen and control click on cameras. And with the move tool, I'm going to move her just past this puzzle so I don't have to play parts of the game to show you what I need to show you. So let's look at the project view. And I'm going to close this art folder and I'm going to go open up prefabs and look at the enemies folder. And here we've got two enemies. We have Chomper and we have Spitter. Chomper is a melee enemy and he's pretty cute. But when you get into his field of view, if I press play and test, he walks back and forth and then he lunges at you and bites you. So I'm going to exit play mode. And I'm not going to use Chomper here, so I'm going to just select him in the hierarchy and press delete to remove him. I am going to put Spitter in though. So Spitter is very much the same, except he doesn't like moving. He doesn't move at all, but he does launch a projectile at you. So if I press play to show you what he does, if I move forward and I'm in his detection zone, he sort of launches these balls of goop at you. So one thing you've noticed when I've dragged in these prefabs is this large green circle that is both on Chomper and Spitter. So one thing you'll notice when I've dragged in Chomper and Spitter is this large green circle here. So on our Spitter, it looks a little bit like a Pac-Man, and this is where he can see you. So this is sort of his field of view and his distance of view. So taking a look at Spitter in the inspector, if I scroll down, I have this enemy behavior component here, and these are all the settings to do with the enemy's behavior. These are the same for both Chomper and Spitter, they're just set up slightly differently. So this is why you'll see, even though it's on Spitter, we have some melee attack data as well as ranged attack. He's using ranged attack, melee attack wouldn't really affect him that much. So what I want to take a look at and show you is the scanning settings in the enemy behavior component. There's a view direction which changes the direction of his vision. And there's the view field of view, which is the FOV here. And that changes sort of how wide he can see. So I don't think he can look behind me because his eyes are kind of facing forward. So I'm going to change that to about 182 degrees or use the slider there. He also has a view distance, which is how far away he can see. I don't think he can see this far away, so I'm going to just change that to here. And I'm also going to orient the direction up because I want him to see me about here for what I want to show you. So now I'm going to add something a little bit different to kill him because he's in this sort of precarious position being below me. I'm going to add a pushable box. So in the prefabs folder, if I go back to interactables, I have a pushable box prefab that I can just click and drag into the scene. I'm going to move this sort of on the edge so it doesn't take too long for me to push it. And after I've added this in, if I press play, Ellen will automatically start pushing the box. But if I push it to the edge and it lands on him, it just kind of bubbles there. It doesn't really do anything and it's not set up to do anything right now. What I can do is, considering that Spitter also, if I take a look at him, he also has a damageable component, and this means again that he can receive damage. So this is how he receives damage from Ellen. His starting health is 1, so if we hit him once he will die. I want to make sure that the pushable box can give damage to this damageable component. If we take a look at the pushable box, it doesn't have any damager components on it. What I can do is add this. So let's take a look at the box, and in the inspector, if I hit add component and type in damage, I'd already typed it in earlier, so you can see it's already set there. We have this damageable component here. And the damager, what we want is the damager, so we're going to click on that. And in the scene view, you can see this green box, which is a collider. And this is the collider that signifies where it's going to give damage. So it's kind of like in an offset position here. It's got these green dots on each edge. What I can do is, in the scene view, click and drag on these green dots and reposition this to where the box is. So you can see the transform gizmo is in the way here. So I'm going to just press Q to get rid of that and then click and drag this to the bottom. I'm going to just overlap it to the bottom to make sure it does definitely collide with our spitter. I think that's about right. Cool. So let's take a look in the inspector, and in the damager component, we have this hittable layers right here. Everything is split out into layers so we can tell different objects of different categories what to do and receive. So if we look at Ellen, click on Ellen in the hierarchy and scroll up in the inspector, I can see that she's on the player layer. And if I take a look at Spitter's prefab, we can see that he's on the enemy layer. So going back to the pushable box and scrolling down to the damager component, right now it's not going to cause any damage to anything because no layers are selected. If I hit everything, this means it will cause damage to everything, so any layer. If I press play and Ellen touches this box, it will cause her damage, which is the opposite of what we want. What we want to do is only set this to cause damage to enemies. So I'm going to select nothing again just to clear the selection. And then I'm going to click on the enemy layer, which is here. Now when I press play and push the box, this will cause damage to our spitter and it's killed him. But it doesn't cause any damage to Ellen. If you'd increase the amount of health, starting health that Spitter has, don't forget to increase the amount of damage that the box has. Right now, they're all set to one health and one damage. Right, so since we're kind of like in a perilous situation here where we're probably going to lose some health, let's look at adding a health pickup. This is fairly simple. We've got a health pickup prefab in the interactables folder, and we just need to click and drag this into the scene. And what this will do is give one health when Ellen walks into it. If she doesn't have any lost health though, it won't do anything. So if I'm really skilled and don't receive any damage here, which I just did, but because I've received damage, she's now able to collect some health automatically. If I start again and try and skill it and not receive any damage, it won't break and give me damage. So it always knows whether to give you damage, whether to give you health or not. So that's already set up for you. Here you can see in the health pickup component, the setting for health amount is 1. If you wanted to give it more health or be able to give it more health, then you'd increase that to whatever you'd like if you increased Ellen's health and 1 isn't enough to give her.